The XFL made its debut over the weekend, and if you had a chance to see any of the games, you probably noticed some interesting differences from the NFL. Forget about talent. The NFL has that on lockdown. But just like the original version of the XFL over two decades ago, this third version of the league plays by some different yet interesting rules. Take the onside kick, which had just a 5.6% success rate last season in the NFL. XFL teams have a secondary option to get the ball back. In the fourth quarter only, teams have the option to try a 4th-and-15 conversion from their own 25-yard line. If they fail, the opposing team takes possession at the spot. Risky, but considering NFL teams successfully recovered just 3 of 56 onside attempts last season, 4th-and-15 doesn't sound so intimidating. Final scores in the XFL will have a mix of numbers, mainly because of the rules surrounding points after touchdowns. In the NFL, you can kick the PAT for 1 point or run a play at the 2-yard line for 2 points. In the XFL, teams can't kick an extra point. Instead, they have 3 options. They can earn 1 point by scoring from the 2-yard line, 2 points by scoring from the 5-yard line, and 3 points by scoring from the 10-yard line. How about the XFL rule on kickoffs? I don't know about you, but it feels like kickoffs have become an exercise in futility in the NFL. Today's kickers have no trouble belting the ball deep into the end zone, so they're unreturnable. XFL teams kick off from the 30-yard line. That's 5 yards further back than the NFL. The kicking team has 10 players lined up down the field at the opponent's 35-yard line, while the returning team has 10 players lined up just 5 yards away from the kicking team at the 30-yard line. The kicker and the returner are the only players who can move until the returner touches the ball. It's an interesting look that's all about player safety. Players aren't speeding down the field into multiple collisions. And with the new rule, between the abbreviated season in 2020 and the opening weekend this season, 97% of kickoffs were returned. Taking all that into consideration, when an NFL team scores a touchdown, you can pretty much walk away, knowing the kicker will nail the extra point and hammer the ball out of the end zone. You just have to get back for the start of the next offensive series. Under the XFL rules, there would be a lot more intrigue in the extra point and the ensuing kickoff. There are a few other tweaks to the game to look for in the XFL, but the only other thing that really stands out for me is the use of instant replay. The XFL has a centralized command center for instant replay review. The broadcast takes viewers right into that center to see the various angles of replays officials are looking at to make their decisions. Initially, it looks to be a faster system and more transparent for fans. Bottom line, the XFL has taught the NFL a thing or two over the years when it comes to innovative use of technology as well as intriguing rule changes. The most recognizable of all is the use of the Skycam, first introduced by the XFL in its inaugural 2001 season. It's now a staple in every NFL broadcast and proof the NFL is watching to see how it can better deliver not only over the air, but on the field as well.